थैंक यू मनोहर। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इट इज गुड टू बी बैक एट टाई 2021। आई एम टोल्ड दैट द रजिस्ट्रेशन हैव एक्सीडेड 40,000, मेकिंग दिस द लार्जेस्ट एवर टाई इवेंट, द लार्जेस्ट एवर एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप कॉन्फ्रेंस एंड द लार्जेस्ट ever gathering of social enterprises in the world. This is indeed the greatest platform for entrepreneurs, and as a fellow entrepreneur, there is no other stage where I feel more at home. I also see that Startup Nation Central from Israel and the government of Costa Rica are partners in this summit. Their participation is the perfect representation of the top two themes of the ongoing global conversations: sustainability and technology. There is no greater country than Costa Rica when it comes to commitment to sustainability. A nation where 98% of its energy needs is met by renewable sources. And there is no greater nation than Israel when it comes to technology leadership. If there were ever a time when the world needed motivated entrepreneurs to help solve the biggest challenges that we have as a humans have perhaps ever faced, that time is now. I'm glad to see that the entire Thai summit this year is devoted to the topic of sustainability. Let me start by setting some context. The COVID-19 pandemic demonstrated the world's inability to react effectively to a multidimensional global crisis that demands coordinated policy responses. It showed how quickly system breakdowns can cascade from one area to the other. It exposed the severe gaps in basic systems, including healthcare, education, mass transit networks, supply chains, and financial markets. The way we have led our lives and done business over the past 50 years cannot continue. At least pandemics like COVID-19 can be countered by vaccines. The Director General of the World Health Organization summarized it well when he said, "There is no vaccine for a climate change. The annual rate of increase in atmosphere carbon dioxide emission since 1970 is up almost 100 times. The search for sustainable solutions starts with admitting that the current situation is unsustainable. An even bigger concern is the impact climate change will have on the poorest segment of the populations. Studies show that the social impact of climate change is irreversible. Therefore, the task before us is not just to find a solution to climate change, but also to ensure through science, policy and technological development that the principle of equitability are not ignored. Solution should allow us to bridge the trade-off between economic, social, privacy and environment policies. A CO2 molecule released in the waste is just as damaging to the east. A CO2 molecule released by the rich is just as damaging to the poor. A CO2 molecule released by the already born is just as damaging to the soon to be born. As an entrepreneur, I stay optimistic. It is my belief that the COVID-19 pandemic has forced us to find the will to kickstart a massive ESG-driven economic transformations. I'm also confident that the most viable climate change solutions will be digital and technology-driven, supported by policies that help accelerate adoptions. My optimism comes from the realization that the impact of the pandemic would have been far more terrible had the digital technologies of today been absent. This should be an indication of the opportunity before us. I also believe this convergence of sustainability and digitization will establish a new disruptive business models that will create the next set of unicorns. This is where organizations like Tide become essential. They enable collaboration across entrepreneurs and investors who see opportunity wherever intersections and friction exist. And the only way we can reduce the friction that sustainability generates in today's business is through the intersection with the technology. Let me now talk about India. Last year, when I spoke here, I had said that over the next 3 decades, India will become a $28 trillion economy. It is now expected that by 2050, India's per capita income will expand from about 1/38 to what that of the United States to 1/3 of the latter's per capita income. That is an astonishing rise. Also in 2050, the median age of the 1.6 billion Indians will still be just 38 years. The world will never ever again see a middle class as large as the one India will have, and that at such a peak consuming age. In addition, the digital acceleration in India is just beginning and will create a tailwind not yet factored into the assumed 8% nominal growth rate. I fundamentally believe the Indian economy is still to hit is inflection point of decades of double digit growth. Therefore, I now think I may have understated my 2050 GDP projections of $28 trillion. Also, given the sheer growth in end consumption rates, I expect India to become the world's top target destination for an immense quantum of FDI over this period, making the tailwind even stronger. While we all realize that the growth models are projections, it is my firm belief that the opportunities India has ahead of it make it the most exciting investment destination on the planet, specifically for technologies that enable sustainability. This nation should be an entrepreneur's dreamland. Let me next discuss the specific opportunity around sustainability and a drill down to where I see the biggest near-term possibility. At the upcoming COP26 summit in Glasgow in November, the world's most powerful countries will lay the foundation for a series of global policy changes. I believe this will be transformational and will accelerate the economic opportunities arising out of the global effort to combat the climate change. As technologies evolve rapidly, this opportunity will equate to trillions of dollars of investment. This include next generation high efficiency solar panels, low carbon materials that make the largest offshore wind turbines affordable, mainstreaming of carbon capture technologies, various fit for purpose battery technologies, algorithm driven smarter and a distributed grids, electric mobility and hydrogen related technologies. Of all these technologies, today solar is the fastest growing source of power. Over the past decade, the price of solar panel has dropped by 90%, and possibly over the next decade, we will see price drops of the same magnitude as panels become even more efficient and new materials come into play. The fact is that the marginal cost of solar power is moving towards zero, and this is both transformative and disruptive. However, as always, it is the combination or intersections of technologies that creates disruptive business models. The combination, which I believe is a game-changing model for sustainability, is that of solar generation and hydrogen productions. It is fascinating that a photon can travel 90 million miles in 9 minutes to heat a piece of silicon on Earth. This in turn generates an electron to split an H2O molecule, leading to the release of a proton, or what we call a hydrogen atom, and now seen as the ultimate source of a dense green energy. In fact, our Earth receives enough photons every hour to meet our global energy needs for an entire year. The ability of this near zero cost electron to economically split H2O molecule and create 100% green hydrogen in the future is a near certainty. Hydrogen is the trigger for the smarter use of other renewables by becoming the long-term transport and distributed storage solution for electricity. It is the key link in the energy transition journey that, along with the wind and solar, will stabilize decentralized power generation. For India, decentralized power generation can be a massive game changer, especially for the rural populations. Decentralized power allows us to improve grid resiliency and micro-size everything. It enables micro-manufacturing, micro-agriculture, micro-healthcare, micro-education, everything that India's rural population today needs for empowerment and job creation. While there are many challenges still to be addressed, I am confident that we are on the cusp of a hydrogen-driven revolution that can transform India, Green India, and Energize India. This is nation building at its best. I would even go as far as to state that the revolution in alternative energy technologies throws open the possibility that someday India can become a net green energy exporter. Hydrogen and its derivatives can replace a significant amount of our imports of a crude oil, natural gas, and coal. This was impossible to even contemplate just 5 years back. Such is the power of unification of technologies that create the most disruptive business models. For an entrepreneur, this is paradise, a landscape of endless possibility, global in nature and spread over decades. What makes all of this even more exciting is the intersection of sustainable energy with the advances in digital technologies. This technology-driven energy transition will disrupt existing industries and at the same time create new ones. Artificial intelligence is now an inevitable universal accelerator. We live in a world where the convergence of powerful and inexpensive computing and the ability to collect a massive amount of data is fast making AI a general purpose technology that will make a tremendous difference to sustainability. Be it the design of distributed grids that enable optimizing the energy sources feeding the grid, or being able to design systems that are self-healing or allowing the micro-sizing of energy, the possibilities are limitless. India, through the sheer strength of its supply and demand for energy, will be among nations best placed to benefit. While this scenario emerged, the Adani Group is not sitting still. We are tripling our solar power generation capacity over the next 4 years. This is a rate of growth currently unmatched by any other company anywhere on the planet. Our renewables portfolio has reached the initial target of 25 gigawatt, a full 4 years ahead of schedule. Today, we are already the world's largest solar power player. This puts well on track to be the world's largest renewable power generating company by 2030. Also, over the next decade, we will invest over $20 billion in renewable energy generations. Our overall organic and inorganic investment across the entire green energy value chain will range between $50 and $70 billion. This will include investment with the potential partners for electrolyzer manufacturing, backward integration to secure the supply chain for our solar and wind generation businesses, and AI-based industrial cloud platforms. We are confident that our integrated value chain, our scale and experience put us on the road to be the producer of the least expensive green electron anywhere in the world. This advantage opens several new pathways for us, including setting us up to be one of the largest green hydrogen producers in the world, thereby opening up additional possibilities to be partner of choice for several other industrial businesses. As I wrap up, I would like to leave you with a message. A few research studies indicate that the Indus Valley civilization underwent a period of climate change about 4,000 years ago. The outcome appears to be uncertain. However, today, we are aware of the effects of a climate change, and the outcome cannot be uncertain. What we need is the will, and who better than the Indus entrepreneur to enable this will? The Thai platform is unmatched in scale, and it must take the responsibility to trigger a movement which brings together an ecosystem of entrepreneurs and investors that work together to build equitable solution for a sustainable world. Congratulations once again for this tremendous event, and thank you for the opportunity to talk to all of you.